crazy, not insane 2020. I think this is interesting because I just watched Angie's review of the same movie. It's a documentary. I can't believe we watched this in the same time frame. That's pretty wild. Anyways, I watched a bootleg, of course, because I don't have HBO Max or Crave, so. And I ain't paying for it either. I ain't gonna give you $5 to watch this. So I found a bootleg stream and I streamed it on the PC. Anyways, it's about the mechanism behind assessing people to see if they're clinically insane or not, so they can stand trial for murder and be executed. Now, people that really support mental health intervention and whatnot are they get kind of down on this whole executing mentally ill people en masse, but quite frankly, that's the majority of people that end up doing horrific murders are mentally ill. So that's not to say that mental illness is going to cause you to do anything bad, because on average, it doesn't. In the vast majority of the times, it doesn't. But it does occasionally. Anyways, really a lot of technical stuff on here. As Angie put it, they kind of waste a lot of time with the psychiatrist or psychologist or whatever the hell she was, messing around with stuff and whatnot. They spent way too much time on that. It could have shortened the documentary if they didn't do that. But anyways, it is boring. But yeah. It's got I forget what it's got on IMDb. It's 6 point something anyways, and I think that's perfectly right. I think it's a six. I would have given it a seven if they didn't waste a lot of time with s unnecessary scenes, basically. And there was a lot of the shrink toting her credentials, basically. So, anyways, it's probably worth a watch if you got HBO or you can find it, like I did. Have a good one.